What's all this then? An airport building? Not in your life. It's the deluxe version of a modern haulage company office. Bit of a change from the old caravan on a bomb site. A glance at the expensive pictures on the wall tells you Kilroy was never here.
John?
Yes, we'll arrive on Monday. Lunedì mattina.
A round trip.
See?
With International Express.
See?
He will be discharging at Sustan
Rossetti. See, okay.
And reloading from Sustan Rossetti in Vicenza.
Who's having tea? Anybody?
Even your cuppa comes courtesy of a computer. What, no teaspoon on a string?
No sugar.
In this Hounslow company, haulage is high tech, and truckers are top drawer. Mind you, the patter doesn't change.
No sugar. You'll get it at that cheap rate.
See these bites I've got come up? See that lot? Where'd you get them?
Watch out, here comes the boss. But don't let the smooth suit fool you. Graham Sensia used to be a driver. He briefs this team for a haul across Europe as matter-of-factly as if he were sending them to Macclesfield.
So you're loaded, are you, for round trip international?
Yeah.
What are you doing? The hilly? Hilly is an unusual run back. So you topped up the
account? It is topping up, yeah.
When you're on your way to port. Monday. But all your vouchers and paperwork must be picked up at Portsmouth from Nightingale.
The truckers have copped for the Italian job. 1,600 miles to Milan and back. They don't advertise the cargoes, bad for security. Every day, something like 2,500 trucks cross the English Channel into Europe. This is the story of three of them.
John, Grant, are you there?
Right, yeah.
Yeah, I'm just arriving, just pulling through now. It's pretty narrow down here, Grant.
Pat Booth has been a trucker all over the world. He works on the principle that if anything can go wrong, it will, even before you leave Portsmouth.
Negative.
Yeah.
Sorry, one left.
An obvious terrorist there.
Funny thing about bureaucrats, they love paper and hate publicity.
It looks about the same size as the two on Dover Run, doesn't it?
Yeah. Hey, have a look on the loading ramp. There's one trying to drive off. I must reverse one on, drive one on. You see, look on the cars on the right, yeah? I bet they let you two drive on and make me reverse on.
Oh, well, you can show them your skills, can't you?
If you come round on my left, it'd be easier. I think you've got more room to swing.
Okay.
holiday motorist who makes a hash of loading his mini metro onto the SeaLink ferry should try this. Maneuvering one of these monsters concentrates the mind wonderfully. No room for thoughts of duty freeze and cheap French plonk. Not much room for another coat of paint either. But these guys make it look easy, in forward or reverse. Out past the British Navy and Portsmouth Harbour, en route to Cherbourg. Beats the hell out of getting stuck behind the army on the A1 at Catterick. Here's a little known fact. A trucker's tummy can rumble in several languages. Now it's chuntering bacon and eggs as the team settles in for their last British breakfast for several days. Truckers are good business for the ferry companies, so they get special treatment. With time to relax, Pat Booth gets to musing about his days driving across Australia, Canada, and the birthplace of trucking culture, the United States.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and you'll earn about $2,000 a week.
How long ago
and then you're dead at the end of the month, of course. Yeah.
How long ago? Though?
Been back just three years, 2 months now.
What were you driving over there? What race?
I actually had a Ford CL9000, but the majority of the trucks were Kenworths. You couldn't put, well, say, a conventional tractor onto a Canadian trailer and send it to New York because you're over length.
Yeah.
So you had to be careful on that. And then you have width restrictions in certain states, and Canadian trailers are wider. They're 8'6" as opposed to 8 foot. So you couldn't go, say, to Wisconsin. If you did, you had to dodge around the weigh scales.
Did you prefer Australia to Canada?
Driving-wise?
Driving, just for the actual work.
No. All drivers load and unload their own rigs over
there.
Yeah? And they're basically a flat semi-trailer with big iron gates and tarpaulins.
Like a rope and sheet job,
yeah.
For everything. How did you rate the Australian drivers, though?
Mad.
Bit of a rare breed,
I mean. Mad. No, they're lunatics.
They're
usually all two up.
Yeah.
Mm. If they're on the long haul. We used to give all the West Coast stuff away, because then we used to have to go across to the Nullarbor Plain, and there wasn't any tarmac. And they reckoned if you got halfway across and you broke down, you had to work out the cost of repair and towing in as opposed to the cost of the load and the truck, because sometimes it wasn't worth even thinking about.
Exchange rates and commission to think of. But the truckers know the ropes.
It's a freight as well, please.
No commission.
No commission,
yeah. It's 975
pounds,
okay?
Yes, okay, thanks. Can I have a ticket as well for the rate?
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye.
I thought you were taking the
for your view.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
Yeah, you got VLAN 7-2, got the
office. Yeah, that's right,
yeah, that's
right. No, it's gone. Southern Coast Guard from Yachtyland, changing to...
British Ferries, Cherbourg, British Ferries, Cherbourg. This is our Granville, Royal Granville. ETA, Cherbourg, 1345 BST. That's 14.
Thank you.
convoy has to face French customs at Cherbourg. The language may be different, but the uniform behaves true to form.
Bonjour. Bonsoir, person.
Je suis.
Ah. Derrière and à fond.
Something's wrong with the paperwork. Well, there would be, wouldn't there? Apparently, the English figure 7 looks like a French figure 1, and it's just not bon enough. What's franglais for? You must be joking, sunshine.
Ah, yeah, difficile, excuse me. Même chose, huh? Primo? First. Where are you? See, these come in sequence, these two trailers. Mine is 9177.
Stroke 2.
What happened then, Pat?
Well, the number was wrong on the carnet, and on the chassis they differed.
Yeah.
So we had to get a new carnet issued. Simple as that.
Got a new one issued?
Yeah.
What, through the AA?
Through the AA, yeah. We got hold of Graham, and he had to authenticate, you know, that he was the boss, and
yeah.
Give his OK, and everything's OK. Play for run our way. Here he comes.
Right.
Yeah.
It costs an on-the-spot £70 fine before the fleet can leave the compound. Not the best of moments to mention Agincourt and Waterloo.
Okay,
tempting, though.
OK, John?
Yeah, you know, yeah, I'm a bit disgusted by myself, but, well, that's the way it goes.
Yeah, c'est la vie, as they say in France.
That's right, yeah.
Change gear much at all, and really get terrific economy.
What's this? France's answer to Barry Sheen? No doubt it hurts his Gallic pride to move over, but it's either that or 150 feet of British heavy metal up his derriere.
Oh, I got it. I put him in the side of the road, didn't I? Yeah, I think if we stay on the old road and then we can find somewhere we can park up and have a meal call it a night, eh?
Well, it's 8:15 now. We don't want to be too late in the restaurant. Well, you're feeling quite hungry now.
Yeah, I am as well. My old tummy's going.
Oh, we'll find somewhere. As long as I've got a bottle of wine, I think I'll be all right.
Nice plate of hors d'oeuvres.
No, there's a Centurulier. It's one thing, Pat. You don't like it, close. Centurulier, they'll be there, won't they?
Roger.
Yeah, go for that, John. Go for the Centurulier. There won't be a weight limit going for that. And that'll be quite good, actually, because we always have showers for the morning.
Credit where it's due, though, one thing the French excel at is food and facilities for truckers. Any one of the French routiers, or transport casts, knocks the stuffing out of your average British greasy spoon. European truckers are provided with proper facilities, ample parking, showers, rooms if you don't want to sleep in the cab, and real value-for-money food with as much free wine as you can drink. It's enough to take your mind off the customs men.
Is he a friend of yours? Is he with us?
How'd you confuse an Irishman? It's an old one. Give him three shovels, tell him to take his pick.
Sorry. You got any contribution?
Yeah.
So anyway. Yeah.
Thanks,
do you like French coffee, John?
I do it.
Yeah, I do. Yeah, I don't mind it at all.
Nice after a meal.
Sure.
A night's sleep in their cabs, and our team wake up full of the joys of spring. Well, some of them.
Any of you guys awake? Time to get up.
Yeah, I'm up. I've got 5 minutes. Job's already over there, mate. He's in the shower, I think.
Oh, well done. Well done. You're good at getting up, aren't you?
How are you doing, John? Any time.
Each working day, the convoy rolls on at a steady 55 miles an hour, up to 38 tons per unit, pulled by some 400 turbocharged horsepower.
Bloody awful weather, isn't it? I mean, it just hasn't stopped since we left Cherbourg. Frenchmen, they just drive like lunatics, don't they?
Well, I suppose having a go at the way the French drive helps to pass the time. French traffic law means the route takes them round Paris on the Périphérique. They're kept well clear of the city, with its flesh pots and pouting French temptresses. Not that a British trucker would even think of such a thing. Yes. Did somebody mention food again?
It's dinner time once again. All we seem to do on this job is sleep and eat. And get paid for it as well.
Another three-course meal with wine and coffee for just a couple of pounds. Eat your heart out, Watford Gap. Compulsory stop coming up. The spy in the cab says it's time to relax. So, our chaps decide to do a bit of fishing. Ah, les Anglais.
Yeah, look at it. It's a likely spot for the fishing on the right here, chaps.
Okay, follow on, let's go.
They're not there for the good of their health. I mean, there's probably something in there.
Have you seen what they pull out? Everything they pull out, no matter what size it is, they keep. I'm surprised there's anything left in their rivers.
Same old story, mate. Have a look around. You don't see many birds, do you?
most drivers will say that they would like to give it up. And many do manage to, but only for a short time. They have 2-3 months back at home, and they're ready to roll. They've had enough, they want to get back on the road, because it's the freedom, I think. You're away from a boss, you're away from other people, you can drive and sit there with your own thoughts, make up your own fantasies, your own dreams, and not be interrupted, not be told what to do. You know what you've got to do, you've got to get from A to B within a certain time, and that's basically it.
The miles are measured in meals. Along the autoroutes, autostradas, and autobahns of Europe, there's a network of staging posts for man and machine. A chance to give the truck a wash and brush up and remove the hordes of kamikaze insects who've been dive bombing the windscreens. East of Calais, the Orcs seem convinced the British can't count.
That's pretty new here, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, it wasn't here when I was here before. Oh, you could sit out, but...
At nearby tables, the French seem to be doing an awful lot of delicate finger work while they eat. You can tell they're no truckers.
No, not bad.
Very nice.
Good.
Yeah.
I only like them for lunch. I don't like pizza if there's a main dinner, you know, in the evening.
You can tell that they're no truckers either.
What do you reckon if we stop at a monkey house tonight?
If we can get covered, mate, it'd be busy.
Down through the south of France now, along tree-lined avenues planted by Napoleon to protect his troops from the sun. Didn't do them a lot of good in the end. The countryside's nice, though, and the little towns.
There's certainly a lot of places that must have folded over the years through the alter routes. People will never get the chance to, you know, experience French routiers, as I remember them. I'm sure they were better before then.
As routiers go, the monkey house is an institution. There's no pet monkey there anymore. He got the boot for disgusting behaviour. But it's still an international gossip shop for truckers, where you hear a dozen languages and 1,000 stories. The food's good, too. But when you look at the meatballs, you wonder what happened to the monkey. Our truckers forego the routier accommodation. The modern cab is like a luxury caravan, a mobile hotel bedroom for 4 nights a week. There's central heating and colour television. Almost all the comforts of home.
pochino ora, ma lo sappiamo fortissimo, in rete linee d'arrivo, attenti allo sentinale di Filbert, comunque è Guimarães che va a vincere, un po' stanco, ci sembra Shanti, no, vince il venezuelano.
Today, the Alps, rising 13,000 feet to divide Europe in two. A variety of spectacular road conditions here, from twisting mountain pass to the motorway. Missing a gear can be a problem with 16 to make a mess of. Dramatic, sometimes dangerous, this pass is the trucker's lifeline into southern Europe. But today's Hannibals don't have to take their mechanical elephants over the top. They've got the famous Mont Blanc tunnel, the longest and highest in the world. 30 years ago, the French started to burrow into the rock from one side and the Italians from the other. When they met in the middle of the 7.5 mile stretch, they were only 5 inches out. They should have employed 2 squads of Irishmen and got 2 tunnels for the price of one. When you've arrived in Italy, the border official thinks he's refereeing a football match between Juventus and Benfica. Another language to cope with too. Oh well, just stick an O at the end of everything and hope for the best.
This week, je ne comprends pas français. Io parlo italiano molto bene.
To confuse matters further, the real customs are administered 20 miles away in Aosta. It can take a whole morning to clear the paperwork. But with a car park 1,000 times bigger than the stage of La Scala, the Brits put on an impromptu performance. No wonder the continental sink were all mad. It could be worse. Italian customs have been known to go on strike for weeks on end. Thank you. finally into Milan by night. With just the loads to drop and the trucks to park, another trucking story ends. Just another trip, another week, another 800 miles. It's a job for a restless soul, an adventurer. Not perhaps for a married man.
You know, I don't feel that because I drive a truck that I should be any different from your average man going to his office or to his factory or whatever. I'm doing an 8-hour day with my lunch hour and coffee breaks. Your restaurant is your social life. So you span that out, you spin it out. Because there's just nothing else to do. Not unless you like the wine, women and song, then fair enough. That's your bag, okay. But not too many drivers into that scene because...
No,
it's a fallacy.
That's the British trucker for you. Dedicated to the job, right to the bitter end.
No, she is nice, though, very nice.
You see, her mother, that's the one. Mm. Oh, dear. Right. How do you think she got it? The mother's the girl.